Welcome. This video is about how people see AI that makes racist decisions. Living in a complex society, individuals have to make so many decisions every day. And, people are now yielding some of them to machines. Even though AI's decisions can create undesirable social outcomes, yet, we still want machines to make decisions on behalf of us. Because humans are complicated and spontaneous, what we want from machines when they make decisions is not simple. Still, we want machines to make fair decisions. But, do they? There have been multiple cases that showed the racial bias of AI. Microsoft's Tay, an AI-based Twitter bot, was shut down because of its racist comments. Another case was Compass, which stands for Correctional Offender Management Profiling for Alternative Sanctions, developed by Northpoint. It is like a future crime prediction in the movie Minority Report. The only difference is that AI, not humans, makes the prediction. However, it is found that the AI made racist decisions. ProPublica reported that Compass was biased against black prisoners, and assigned them a higher probability of committing future crimes than white prisoners with a similar crime record. Also, after looking into the risk scores of about 7,000 arrested people in Florida and their crime relapses over the next 2 years, the investigation found that only 20% of Compass predictions were correct. We wanted to see whether people attribute responsibility toward AI just as they do toward humans, or not. We need theoretical frameworks to understand this. One is Computers Are Social Actors by Clifford Ness. Computers Are Social Actors, CASA, is a paradigm which states that humans mindlessly apply the same social heuristics used for human interactions to computers. Defensive attribution is another one. It claims that people tend to blame more when a perpetrator is dissimilar to themselves. Based on this perspective, we anticipated that in a blamable situation involving an AI and a human crime predictor, people would be more likely to accuse AI. It is because people feel more dissimilarities from AI crime predictors than human predictors. Also, it is expected that crime predictors will receive less blame if a defendant in given scenarios committed a more serious crime. Because the severity of the crime is found to have a positive relationship with perceived dangerousness, crimes with more serious outcomes may induce more trust in decisions by an authority. Finally, we thought the predictor's autonomy plays a crucial role. These are the hypotheses of this study. Hypothesis 1. A lower rating on autonomy will be given to a crime predictor in the AI crime predictor scenario compared to the human crime predictor scenario. Hypothesis 2. The level of blame to the crime predictor's decision is positively related to its autonomy in both human and AI crime predictor scenarios. Hypothesis 3. Participants will attribute more responsibility to a crime predictor in the AI crime predictor scenario than the human crime predictor scenario. Hypothesis 4. Participants will blame a crime predictor less when the crime in the scenario is more serious. To test these, I showed the Compass article to 334 participants about the AI program giving higher risk points to blacks than whites with a similar crime record. To one group, we told that the crime predictor was a human. I told the other group that the crime predictor was artificial intelligence. Also, to manipulate the seriousness of crime records, I showed one group a case with a light crime record, which was petty theft, and the other group with a heavier one, DUI. So, it was a 2x2 design. It is found that both the seriousness of the crime and the identity of crime predictors did not influence the perception of racist decisions. On the other hand, people think that human crime predictors are more autonomous than AI when making racist decisions. Finally, we found the relationship between autonomy and blame was similar in both AI and human predictor cases, which supports CASA. But, what was the reason for no main effect outcome? We thought these results might be due to a ceiling effect. In other words, the reason there was no difference between human and AI may be because people thought racism is terrible and unforgivable anyway, no matter who did it. For those who want to know more about this study, this paper is published in Computers and Human Behaviors. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it.